adding and subtracting integers. This video will help you add integers with the same signs, add integers with opposite signs, and subtract integers. Let's take a look at a definition here first. Together, whole numbers and their opposites make up the integers. So if we're looking at our list of integers here, the whole numbers start at zero and then add the counting numbers to it, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and go on forever to the right there. Now, if we take those counting numbers and then make their opposites now, then we're going to get these kind of negative counting numbers going off in the other direction. They're -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, going on forever off to infinity. But one thing specific to notice about the integers, that the integers go by increments of 1, meaning we're going to go right from 0 then to 1, 2, 3, 4. We're not going to include any fractions or decimal numbers here. Another thing to note here is that 0 is kind of right in the middle. It's neither positive nor negative. When adding integers with the same sign, such as -1 plus -2, we add them to get a total. When we add the same kinds of things together, we get more of those things. For example, if I take and add 1 pen plus 2 pens, I'm going to get 3 pens, because those are the same kinds of things we're adding together. Same thing happens here with integers. If I take -1 and add 2 more negatives to it, I'm going to get a total of 3 negatives. So we can visualize sine disks to kind of see how this total works. I have 1 of these negatives here, and then I'm going to add 2 more of these negatives to get a total of 3 negatives. Now let's take a look at an example that will help you understand how to use sine disks to add integers with the same signs. So we're going to start here again, 2 negatives, so 1, 2 negatives, plus 4 negatives. And so we're adding things here that are the same. So if I start with 2 of these things and add 4 more of these things, altogether I'm going to get 6 of those negatives. Question 2, we're adding -9 plus -8. Well, we know our answer is going to be negative because we're adding these things together. If I take 9 of these things and add 8 more of those things, I'll have 17 of those negatives. Now go ahead and pause your video player and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, practice question 3. We're going to use sine disks to add these together here. So we should have written 3 negatives plus 1 more negative to give us a total of 4 negatives. And then down here, -12 plus -11. Well, we're going to get a total of negatives here. And in fact, we're going to get a total of 23 negatives for our answer there. Adding integers with opposite signs. We can also visualize sine disks to add integers with opposite signs. When a positive disk is added to a negative disk, the result is 0. So to add a +3 plus -1, we can visualize the positive and negative disks kind of canceling out, and the result is what's going to remain. So if you take a look here, I have 3 positives and 1 negative. Well, every time I combine a positive and a negative together, it gives me 0. So this pair kind of zeros out. And so what's left over then is 2 positives. And that's how I get an answer of +2 when I add +3 plus -1. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to add positive and negative integers. All right, so question 5, example 5 here, we're going to ask to... So example 5, it add using sine disks. So I'm going to say, okay, there's 6 positives there. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll put some circles around those things. 6 of these positives. Oops. Plus 2 negatives. Well, this positive and that negative, we can kind of think of those zeroing out. And this positive and this negative, we can think of those zeroing out. And so what we'll have left then is we'll have 4 positives. And so you can write the answer +4 like that, or you can write the plus sign in front to mean +4. Either answer is good. Example 6. Add by visualizing the sine disks. Well, now we're taking a look at 60 plus -68. Drawing out 60 disks is not going to help us here. But here's what we can do. We can ask these 2 questions, and it will kind of use the idea of sine disks to get to our answer. Here are the questions we're going to ask. Do we have more positives or more negatives? Well, let's take a look here. 60 positives and 68 negatives. So we're going to have more negatives. So that means our answer, the sign of our answer, is going to be negative. And then how many more? Well, how many more negatives comes down to this? I basically just go 68 minus 60. And I can see that I'm going to have 8 more negatives here. So then my answer is going to be negative 8. Example 7. Let's see. More negatives or more positives? I have more negatives. How many more? Well, let's take a look. 35 minus 16. So we'll have to subtract to do this. So I'm going to have to borrow from the 3, which will make it a 2, which will make this a 15. 15 minus 6 gives me 9. 2 minus 1 gives me 1. So it looks like we had 19 more negatives there. So we get an answer of negative 19. Okay, now it's time to check your understanding of adding positive and negative integers together. Pause your video player and answer these questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 8, add using sine disks. All right, well, I have 3 negatives, 1, 2, 3 negatives and 5 positives. Okay, these are going to zero out. So 3 of them are essentially going to cancel out and we'll be left with 2 positives. So I get an answer of positive 2. Practice 9, well, do we have more negatives or more positives? Well, we have more negatives. How many more negatives? Looks like 100 more negatives there. Practice question 10. Adding positives, negatives. We have more positives, so I know my answer is going to be positive there. How many more? Well, let's find out. If we take 48 minus 15, that looks like 33 more positives. Subtract integers. To subtract integers, we change the subtraction problem to an addition problem by adding the opposite. For example here, to subtract a positive, we add a negative. So here I have the question, 6 minus a positive 3. To change that, I'm going to do 2 steps. First, I'm going to change the subtraction sign to an addition sign. Now, to counteract that or kind of compensate for that, I also have to now add the opposite of what I originally started with. I was originally adding a positive 3, so now I'm going to add a negative 3. To subtract a negative, add a positive. So here I have a situation where I'm 4 minus a negative 2. So now I want to do the opposite twice here. So instead of subtraction, I'm going to change it to addition. And now I started out with a negative 2, so I now want to change that to its opposite as well, which is a positive 2. And you can see how this complicated problem here, 4 minus negative 2, that will have the same answer as this 4 plus 2 and 4 plus positive 2. That's a pretty easy answer to come up with. We've done that one for years. We know the answer there is 6. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to subtract integers. Example 11. So I want to change this now to an addition problem. First one stays the same. So negative 7. I'm going to change this to addition. Now to do that, I got to now add the opposite. Originally, we were starting with a positive 12 here. That was minus a positive 12. So I now want to add negative 12. And you can see here that we're adding numbers now with the same sign. So we're going to get more of those numbers. Negative 7 plus negative 12 altogether, that's going to give me 19 negatives. Example 12. Let's see here. So first one stays the same. Subtraction now is going to become addition. I was originally subtracting a positive 26. So I want to change that to its opposite as well. So that's negative 26. Okay, let's take a look. Now I'm adding opposites here. Do I have more negatives or more positives? More negatives. How many more? It looks like 12 more. Okay, example 13. Negative 4 minus a negative 2. Well, again, the first one stays the same. I want to change this minus sign now to addition. And now I want to add the opposite. I was originally subtracting a negative 2, so now I want to add a positive 2. And so when I add those together, it looks like I'm adding opposites, and I have more negatives. In fact, 2 more negatives. Now it's time to check your understanding of subtracting integers. Go ahead and pause your video player and answer practice questions 14 and 15, and when you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, question 14. Again, we're asked to subtract. We want to turn this to addition by adding the opposite. So it'll become 10 plus positive 12. And you could write the parentheses there or not write the parentheses. It doesn't make a difference. So now I'm just adding two positive numbers together. 10 plus positive 12 is going to give us 22. Question 15, now I want to add the opposite, so this is going to become 5 plus, originally this was a positive 22. Now I'm going to make it a negative 22. You can see here we're adding opposites. Looks like I have more negatives. How many more negatives? It looks like 17 more negatives. Go ahead now and pause your video player again. Now we're going to do some mixed practice with both addition and subtraction. Go ahead and work through all of these questions, and when you're done, hit play and I'll give you the answers. Okay, so take a look at these first problems and check your answers and see how you did. If you got one that doesn't match my answer there, go back and rework it and see if you can come up with the correct answer. Go ahead now and pause your video player again and answer these next practice questions. When you're done, hit play and I'll give you the answers. Go ahead and check your answers against mine here. If you have any that you got a different answer than what I have, go back and rework it and see if you can come up with the correct answer.